Now, a square pyramid of 35 mm side of base and 60 mm axis length rests on HP on one of its edges of the base. Draw the projections of the pyramid. Draw the projections of the pyramid when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees and to VP at 30 degrees. So this is the problem which is given. Since an axis length rests on HP on one of its edges of the base, the edge which is resting on HP has to be perpendicular to VP. So which is the edge which is perpendicular to VP? AD is the edge which is perpendicular to VP, and also BC is also the edge which is perpendicular to VP. That is quite evident. We have placed this three-dimensional solid on AD which is perpendicular to VP, and also the BC which is also a perpendicular to VP. So here when you look from the front view, I can see the height of the pyramid. The height of the pyramid is 60 mm. So that will going to be on the vertical plane. And when you look from the top view, I can see the base which is AB, BC, CD and DA, which is the base edge of the side, 35 mm. So we are going to get a square of 35 mm. And when you look from the front view, AB is near to the observer, so A dash B dash is visible, and C and D is away from the observer, C dash D dash is invisible. Similarly, O1 dash will become invisible and O dash will going to be the visible point, because when you look from the front view, O is visible, so O dash is visible here. Similarly, when you look from the top view, ABCD is visible, so ABCD is visible, and also O is near to the observer, so it is visible, and O1 dash is away, O1 is away from the observer, so that becomes invisible. So the same thing which will be have to look into the orthographic view here. The AD is the base edge which is made perpendicular to VP, and complete the square by drawing a 35 mm line, and then by using the protractor you measure an angle of 90 degree, and then draw a line from A and also from D. By using the compass you can cut it here on B and also from C to get the square of 35 mm side, and join the diagonals with a dark line, because OA, OB, OC and OD are the slant edges. OAB is a triangular face, OBC is a triangular face, OCD is a triangular face, and ODA is the triangular face. So here, when you look from the front view, AB is near to the observer, so it is visible. CD is away from the observer, it becomes invisible. So here, O dash is a visible point, A dash is a visible point, so visible to visible is visible. Similarly, O dash is a visible point, B dash is a visible point, visible to visible is visible. And similarly, A dash is a visible point, B dash is a visible point, visible to visible is visible. So we are going to get a triangle. You can see O dash, B dash, C dash is a triangular face which is perpendicular to VP, and O dash, A dash, D dash, which is also a triangular face which is perpendicular to VP. This you can see when you look from the top view, OAD is a triangle, similarly OBC is a triangle. So this is how we are going to get the first, the initial position of the object, initial position of the solid. Then when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees, since now here, since the axis OO1 is parallel to VP, so I am getting the true length here. So the inclination given is also a true inclination. Since the inclination given is also a true inclination, so naturally we will going to be able to rotate the in the second position such that the axis will be inclined at 45 degrees. So here, since one of the edges is resting on HP, so we are making that A dash D dash on XY line, and then draw a line by using the protractor. You measure an angle of 45 degree with respect to the XY line, and then draw a line, and then by using the compass you measure the length from A dash to B dash. From A dash you cut an arc to get this point B dash C dash. Similarly, from A dash you measure the length of A dash to O1 dash. From A dash you cut an arc on this to get this point O1 dash. Through O1 dash, by using the protractor, you measure an angle of 90 degree with respect to the line A dash B dash, and then draw a perpendicular to that inclined line A dash B dash. And then from here, from O1 dash, by using the compass, you measure a height of 60 mm, and then from O1 dash you cut an arc on that perpendicular line to get this point O dash, and then join all these points O dash A dash and O dash B dash to complete the triangle exactly similar to the first position front view. Now we need to write the top view. So to write the top view, draw a vertical projector from O dash and draw a horizontal projector from O to get this point O. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from O1 dash and draw a horizontal projector from O1 to get this point O1. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from A dash D dash and draw a horizontal projector from A and also from D to get this point AD. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from B dash C dash and draw a horizontal projector from BC to get this point BC here. So then join all these points by using a continuous thin lines. Join between A to B, B to C, C to D and D to A, and then join between O to A, O to B, O to C and O to D, and join this OO1 with a center line. Now all these things which has to be done by using the continuous thin lines, now to see that we are going to get the exact boundary. So here now we have to apply the condition of visibility. All the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids are visible. So OA, AB, BC, CD and OD all are on the boundary of the solid. So exterior edges of the boundaries of the solid, so it is visible. So you draw this. Then when you look from the top view, O dash, B dash, C dash is a triangular face. That is OBC is a triangular face. When you look from the top view, it becomes visible. So you draw this line OC and OB. Once you join these two, so this will be a continuous dark line and this will be a continuous dark line. Now we want to check whether AD is visible or not. So we have next condition, the two visible edges can never cross each other. Since OC and OB are the visible edges, so naturally AD will become invisible because two visible edges can never cross each other. So by applying that condition, so AD will going to become invisible. Since AD is invisible in the rectangle of ABCD, so naturally O1 becomes invisible. So O1 will be in bracket.